Hi guys, it's Vin with Boris Effects, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use Corner Pin Studio to quickly and easily pin text to a wall inside of After Effects. Okay, so here we are in AE, and I have my original footage of this young woman walking down an alleyway. I wanted to use this footage because not only does it have a nice defined wall for us to attach text to, but she moves in front of it, so we'll get some quick masking tips to really help sell this effect. I've also added some AE text to the top track that we're going to use as our insert. To do this, let's head to the Match Move category and drag BCC Corner Pin Studio right onto our background track. The first thing I want to do is change the workflow to Apply to Background. It's important that we select this particular workflow because it's going to allow us to pull the background layer into Mocha in a moment. To do this, I'll set my foreground insert layer to my titles and then enable Composite over Background. Now when I do this, I'm going to see two instances of the text. The first is the Corner Pin text. And the second is the main text track. Since we don't need to see the text track, let's just disable the track visibility. And there you go. With the correct workflow selected, I'm going to go to my Mocha motion tracker and launch my custom UI. Inside of Mocha, I have my two tracker elements, my search area and my corner pin guide. Now this box represents each of the four points of my corner pin. Now your first thought may be to keep the search area and the corner pin connected. After all, we want the corner pin to match the movement of our motion tracker. But here's the thing. Mocha is a planar tracker, so it's tracking all the pixels within our search area. This is going to become a problem if we want our text on the wall, because as soon as she passes in front of it, Mocha will lose the track. So what do we do? Well, as I said, Mocha is a planar tracker, which means that as long as we track something along the same plane as our corner pin, we'll get the results we want. And as luck would have it, there's a window up here along the same plane as the wall I want to apply my text to. So I'll set my search area to track the movement of this window. My corner pin, I'm going to place against the wall. Now I can turn on the grid to make sure it lines up nice and evenly, tweaking it as necessary. When done, I'll hit track, and there you go. When satisfied, hit apply, and our text has been tracked to the wall. I can open up my transforms control to make adjustments to the scale and translation. It's a lot easier to fine-tune the position this way because regardless of any changes I make, it's going to maintain our motion tracking. When satisfied, I can play that back, and that's looking pretty great. Now what we want to do now is mask out the text as she walks in front of us. To do this, I'm going to go down to Mocha Pixel Chooser. Now make special note that this is not the Mocha motion tracker that we just used. In fact, I'm going to close that group since we're done with it. Mocha Pixel Chooser will use the same power of Mocha tracking, but allow me to mask out part of the effect. Now how detailed you want to get will naturally depend on the effect you want to achieve. You can go in and create roto masks for her arms, head, body, and track them individually. But for this tutorial, I'm just going to create a quick garbage mask that more or less follows our woman. To do this, I'm going to select my brush tool and quickly draw a shape that matches her body. When done, I'll click the arrow and create a mask. Next, I'll track forward, keeping an eye on the movement of her arms and pausing ever so often to adjust the mask. While Mocha will not display the composited text, I do know that it's in this area. So I'm going to make sure that anytime she's positioned here, I keep the mask as tight to her as I can. I'll pause the track, select some points, and manually adjust. And I'll just continue to do that until she's past the sign. When satisfied, I'll hit apply and my text disappeared. Why did this happen? Well, we just told Mocha that the effect is in this area. What I need to do is click Invert Mask here in the Pixel Chooser Mask group, and that will invert the effect, masking out the text only when she is in front of it. If I need to make any adjustments, I can always jump back into Mocha and tweak that mask. But essentially, that's pretty much it. All that's left is to make a few final tweaks to really sell the effect. And the great thing is that Corner Pin Studio makes it very easy to do all that within the effect itself. First, I'm going to come down and feather my Mocha mask. I'm talking ever so slightly, maybe a pixel or two. Any more, and you'll draw attention to the masking, and the effect will look very weird. Next, let's enable Light Wrap. This will reflect the luma from the background layer onto our foreground layer. Just nudge that up a bit to soften the edges of the text, making it look like it's part of the scene. Don't do too much, or it'll look feathered. Lastly, these titles really stick out like a sore thumb. I want to make them look like they're part of the wall. To do that, I'm going to open up the composite group and change the apply mode to overlay. When I play that back, We have quickly and easily added text to a wall within the scene. And while I did this with text, you can absolutely use a still image or other object using the exact same steps. Now, since these are titles, I can always enable drop shadow if I want them to pop off that surface. But as far as creating this effect inside of After Effects, that's all there is to it. I'm Vin Morreale with Boris Effects, and for more great tutorials, don't forget to check out the Boris Effects website. Take care!